So in the today's class, we are going to discuss about two more laws. So that two laws are, one is called associative law and second one is called as distributive law. So in the associative law, we have again two theorems, and in distributive law, we have two theorems. First, concerning to this associative law, in this there are theorem 1 and theorem 2. So this theorem, the associative law for addition is there, and the second one is the associative law for multiplication. It means these are the two theorems. One is concerned to addition operation and second one is concerned to multiplication operation, that is all operation and add operation can be checked again with the help of this associative law. In the question, how to prove this? Same as what you have proved in the previous theorems. So take the theorem number 1 in the associative law for addition. Right? Then, case 1, if x equal to 0, take LHS, we will get some result. Then, take RHS, substitute the value of x as 0, and you will get the result. Then compare that. If both are same, that x equal to 0 is proved. In the same way, second case, take x equal to 1, take the LHS, get the output, and take the RHS, get the output, again compare that too. If both are matching, then again the theorem is proved. Then you can write that LHS equal to RHS and the theorem is proved. This is algebraic method. And second method is again as usual, that is by using truth table method, that also will prove. First, we'll start with the algebraic method, that is theorem number 1 for associative law, that is x plus y plus z equal to x plus y plus z. The groupings are different here. So from this theorem, first in the proof, take if x equal to 0. If x equal to 0, then take the LHS. LHS equal to x plus of y plus z. Then substitute the value of x as 0. So x is there, its value is 0 plus inside bracket y plus z. So we have learned theorem 0 plus x is x. So based on that, we can get that this first term and the second term, then the result I will take as 0 plus y plus z is nothing but y plus z. Right? 0 plus y plus z is nothing but y plus z. This is first one. And check out the second one. Right? So, RHS you can take. Take the RHS, that is x plus y plus z. Then x value is 0. So take that 0 plus y plus z. This is nothing but again y plus z. It means if x equal to 0, LHS is y plus z, RHS is also y plus z. It means LHS equal to RHS. This is for the case if x equal to 0. In the same way, we can take another part, that is if x equal to 1. If x equal to 1, then as you will again take LHS. So LHS is equal to that x plus of y plus z, that is equal to the value of x as 1. So 1 plus of y plus z, that is equal to, what will get? Consider this as completely and x and the consider madi. Because you learned one theorem, 1 plus x equal to, what was that? Anybody remember? that is nothing but 1. So 1 plus x is nothing but 1, that is modulo 1. So based on that, this total bracket and this is as a single term. So 1 plus this term is nothing but, I can see this as x. So 1 plus x, it is nothing but 1. 1 plus something is nothing but 1. Account of 1 plus x equal to 1. Here. So take care. RHS equal to x plus y plus z. So I guess the value of x as 1 here. So 1 plus y plus z. Right? So 1 plus y plus z will get. So what will get again for the next step? Again, you can write it as 1 plus y plus z is equal to 1 plus y plus z, that is equal to 1. That is equal to, we can write it as LHS equal to RHS. Hence, the theorem is proved. Right? So, this is the way you can prove the theorem by taking LHS and RHS. So this is the method of proving the theorem algebraically. Once you know this, then you go for the second method called as by using truth table. So now, this is the theorem. You have to observe the theorem now. What are things given in this? How many number of variables are there in this theorem? When you observe this key region, x is 1, y is second one, and z is there. So here also x, y, z. So there are total 3 variables are there in the theorem. The number of variables are 3. You don't ask n equal to 3. So the number of variable equal to 3. Then I know that the general form is 2 power n. So where n is 3, now such a value of n as 3, that is equal to 2 into 2. When you expand this 2 power 3, the expanded form is 2 can be multiplied 3 times. So the 2 into 2 is 4. So 4 into 2 is 8, it means this particular truth table requires 8 rows. Total we need 8 rows to prove this theorem by using truth table. Now, after this first part, then check out. 8 rows are required. 8 rows for different combination of values, then 1 row for writing reading. Total. You have to draw 9 rows. So we'll draw now. So first row, second row, third row, fourth row, fifth row, 6th row, 7th row, 8th row, and 9th row. So I got 9 rows, 1 for heading purpose, remaining 8 for different input purpose. And not close still because we have to make number of columns. So now for writing the column headings, observe carefully what are the things we need so that you can get this LHS equal to RHS. First, I will initially column X, column 1, columns are three variables are there. Three separate columns are required. First column I just write x. So this is my first column. The second is second variable that is y. And third is z is there. So from this theorem, there are three variables. So there are three variables, three columns we have done. Fine. What is the next step? Next step is x is there, we know that. To complete this LHS, what we need, that can to write it now. So x is there plus y, then this bracket is we need. So once I know that y plus z, then I can plug that value to x, so then I get complete LHS. So x is there, we need y plus z. Y is there, z is there. Next, what are the values? Next column has y plus z. Like this, you have to print the expression and print the columns. So y plus z also is gone. So x is there. What do I need? To get the complete LHS, and then full now LHS x plus y plus z as the next column. So x plus y plus z. So here we have completed complete LHS part here. By using five columns. Clearly, LHS is over. Now think of RHS. How do we get the RHS? Z is there. No need to rewrite again. X plus Y, not there. So write this as the next column, that is X plus Y. So X plus Y. So once you know the X plus Y value, then add Z back to that. So that is going to complete RHS. So right now, this column is the last column of the table, that is x plus y plus z. So this is now, the fifth table is ready now with the columns. Now the thing is, you have to write the different combination of values for these three variables x, y, z. It is very simple because you are all familiar with the binary numbers. That's why it is very easy. So in case of two variables, you have written binary numbers by using two bits 0001, 10, and 11. The same way, for three variables, you have written binary numbers with three bits. Three-bit binary number you can write so that automatically you get different set of inputs. So write it as first x, y, z is there. First we'll write it as x is 0, 0, 0. Starting with 0. 0 can be written in 3 bit as 0, 0, 0. Then 1 in 3 bit 0, 0, 1. And next, after 1, 2 is there. So I know that 0, 1, 0. So for 2 variables, I am adding only this. But for 3 variables, one more 0 we are adding. So 0, 1, 0 is over. Then 3, 0, 1, 1. If you avoid this, these are nothing but two variables, different combination of values. But for 3, a query is like this, but here are the changes. After 3, the binary value 4 is 1, 0, 0. And 5 is 1, 0, 1, and 6 is 1, 1, 0, and 7 is 1, 1, 1. If you write the binary numbers 0 to 7 for three variables, they are given different combination of values as an input for the three variables. Very easy because we are familiar with binary numbers. So, all these we know, then perform the required operation, nothing is there because column headings are ready. You have to perform the operation what is needed to get the result. So So in the next column, what is there? That is Y plus Z is there. So Y is here, Z is here. All these two values, whatever result you get, that is nothing but this one value. So 0 or Z, it is 0 plus Z, then Y plus Z is 0 plus 0. So 0 plus 0 is nothing but 0. In the same way, 0 plus 1 is nothing but 1. 1 plus 0 is 1. 1 plus 1 is 1. 0 plus 0 is 0. 0 plus 1 is 1. 1 plus 0 is 1. And 1 plus 1 is 1. So this completes Y plus Z. We have all the zeros and ones. Our operation is completed. Then you can check out Y plus Z is ready. This column, Y plus Z is there in the next column. And for that, X value should be added. It means these are things. X plus Y plus Z is nothing but new column at the next column. So 0 plus 0 is nothing but 0. Then 0 plus 1, 1. 0 plus 1, 1. 0 plus 1, 1. 1 plus 0, 1. 1 plus 1, 1. 1 plus 1, 1. And the last value of 1 plus 1 is 1. This is about the LHS we got now. X plus Y plus Z equal to 0, 1, 1, 1, and all the remaining are 1 pair getting. In the same way, get the RHS and compare. To get the RHS, first we are going with the bracket that is X plus Y. In the bracket X plus Y is there, there is one column so that once you get the bracket value, for that you can add the Z value to get the complete RHS. So find the X plus Y, it means these are two values. 0 plus 0, see 0 plus 0 is 0. 0 plus 0, 0. 0 plus 1, 1. 0 plus 1, 1. 1 plus 0, 1. 1 plus 0, 1. 1 plus 1, 1. And the last one is also 1 plus 1. So that is 1. So what do you got in the RHS? The bracket X plus Y we got. So once we know the X plus Y, for that you can add the value Z to get the complete RHS. It means for this value X plus Y, you can add the value of Z. That becomes the RHS value. So complete that. X plus Y is 0, 0 plus Z value is 0, 0 plus 0 is 0. Then 0 plus 1 is 1. Right? Then 1 plus 0, these are two values. 1 plus 0 is 1. 1 plus 1 is 1. 1 plus 0, 1. 1 plus 1, 1. 1 plus 0, 1. And last one, 1 plus 1 is again 1. So, after completing this fifth table, now you have to check whether your theorem is proved or not just by observing the LHS column and RHS column. The LHS column is here. LHS column, I will mark it as log, and log it into it. This is LHS, and RHS is this one. This is called log it. Now check out, LHS is equal to RHS or not? 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 3, 4, 1, 6 means the LHS is equal to RHS. Theorem is true. This is the method we call it as by using truth table. The theorem is true. That is, associative law for addition is proved by using truth table. Then, in the same way, you have to prove it that associative law for multiplication also. Associative law for
multiplication.
So this associative law for multiplication, just you check yourself. The method is same. Practice. What then you do? Take x equal to 1, then take LHS and take RHS, then check the output. Both are same. The whole theorem is proved. LHS equal to RHS, so hence the theorem is proved. So this theorem is similar to this addition. Only change is only multiplication of the both, right? You have to practice this yourself in two methods. First, you have to go with algebraic method, and second one with the help of truth table. So next, what I'll do is we'll go with the distributive law, right? Next law is called as distributive law. So distributive law, in that the first theorem is x into y plus z equal to xy plus xz. X into y plus z is equal to xy plus xz. This will prove now. This theorem is over. This theorem is over yourself because both are similar. Now I'm going with this distributive law, and that x plus y plus z. So x into y plus z equal to x y plus x z. How to prove this theorem? Again, by using both the methods. That is, first you can prove it by using algebraic method, and secondly, we'll complete with by using truth table method. So now, by using algebraic method, again consider if x equal to 0, take LHS, LHS equal to x into y plus z, x of y plus z, everything done is practice that. What is that? X into of y plus z. So substitute value of x as 0 here. So 0 into y plus z. 0 dot x, you can remember the theorem what we learned in the earlier classes, that is 0 dot x is nothing but 0. This is first output we got when x equal to 0. You take the RHS. The RHS is xy plus xz. So xy plus xz. Again, here also the simple value of x as 0. So x is there, so 0 dot y plus x is there, 0 dot z. So 0 dot y is nothing but 0 plus 0 dot z is nothing but 0, right? So 0 plus 0, we know that by using for relation, I mean 0, it means we have proved that if x equal to 0, LHS is 0, RHS is also 0. So LHS equal to RHS. First case is true. In the same way, you can take if x equal to 1, then true that. If x equal to 1. So if x equal to 1, take LHS. LHS equal to x dot y plus z. Substitute the value of x as 1. So 1 dot y plus z. So 1 dot x, another there. 1 dot x is nothing but x. So based on that, we will make that 1 dot y plus z. This is nothing but x. So 1 dot y plus z is nothing but y plus z. Now take the RHS. For the same x value as 1, so RHS is nothing but xy plus xz. So substitute value of x as 1, so 1 dot y plus 1 dot z. So by theorem we have learned 1 dot y is nothing but y, The theorem is called as 1 dot x equal to x you have learned. So here 1 dot y is equal to y. In the same way, by the same theorem, if you apply for 1 dot z, again what you get is 1 dot z equal to z. So if you observe now the electric output and electric output, there is y plus z, and y plus z are looking for x equal to 1. Hence, the theorem is proved. That is, distributive law is proved. This is algebraically we have. Now, in the same way, we go with that using truth table also.